Let's see how he performs now.
One.
Well, that kicked up, didn't it, off the serve?
Yes, smart long serve, the very first one. Generally don't see that on the men's side of the game.
Tell us a bit more about that. Why you would see less of that in the men's game than the women's game with those long serves?
Yeah, you'd like to generally keep it short because you want to get an early opening and then for your attack. So generally the men keep it really short, closer to the net. And seeing the first serve go long, for me at least, is surprising.
Well, it's a decent start here. Isaac Quirk, he wants to keep pace with his opponent, doesn't he? Being within striking distance, not allow his opponent to really surge ahead of him. There's that arm. Look at how strapped up it is.
Yeah, and let's talk a bit about injuries. Right. Table tennis is such an intense sport. Mm. We spoke about it earlier. You use a lot of your shoulder, the forearm, a lot of wrist work, back, core, knees, whatnot.
Yeah, I was talking to the Portuguese team doctor, and she was saying what players do in table tennis, and you'll know this well, Neha, is actually unnatural for the body. The kind of stress you're putting on it, it's not what the body's used to. It's not what it, not a lot of it's not. Not natural for, you know, especially shoulder, arm, and back.
Yeah, I like to put it like athletics and chess combination is what table tennis is. Because you need fitness levels at the highest, like it is in athletics, and also the mental strength, the strategizing, and the intelligence, like it is for the chess champions.
5-3.
So it's a 2-point lead. Yeah, I don't think he wants to let Lin Winru go anything more than maybe 2 to 3 points at this stage.
6-3.
Just a little hand of acknowledgement there from Lin Winru. That came off right off the end of the table.
Seven.
We saw him go right through the paces on this table, as Neha mentioned, about an hour and a half before we started. Just looking to get used to these conditions. It was just 4 days ago that he got those gold medals that Neha was referring to at the Southeast Asian Games.
Yeah, but Lin Winru taking a super early lead in this first game. And he's the only Chinese Taipei player in the top 10 in the world.
It's
a lot of hopes, a lot of pressure on himself as well to prove his medal.
Yes, best performance in international events. As you can see, the momentum, 7 of 8, was the World Cup bronze in 2019 in Chengdu.
10-3.
Lots of game points here for Lin.
11-3.
Which he wraps up very comfortably indeed. 11-3. Lin Winru takes the first game. I just wonder, Neha, and you know, you can recount on your experiences at the first World Championship. There's got to be nerves as well when you're playing such a high-ranked player. He's playing a top 10 player. He doesn't get many opportunities like this. There's got to be nerves playing into this somewhere, right?
100%. I remember playing my first World Championships in 2006. Was as a 16-year-old.
Well, there you go. Very similar. Yeah.
Very similar. And just the atmosphere, the fact that you're representing your country at the biggest stage means a lot. And there is a lot of nerves. There is excitement. And it's totally up to you how you take it. I feel Quek is doing brilliantly.
Yeah.
He's trying all his level best.
That's a lovely winner, isn't it, as well on the backhand.
He's
regarded as the next big hope for Singapore. And as mentioned, yep, born in Singapore as well. Singapore, a long time, used to have China-born players. And there's a whole new era of local-born players that are coming through the system now. And they did very well. You mentioned the Commonwealth Games. They were the second most, after India, they were the second most successful nation at the Commonwealth Games last year. Cleaned up at these recent SEA Games. That's the Southeast Asian Games.
That was a beautiful long push, totally towards the end line.
Yeah, he seems to have just settled a bit more, hasn't he?
Yeah, and trying to get your early attacks is the real strategy. I mean, to me, sometimes it's a no-brainer that you need to get your early attacks and attempt those balls, which he's doing that very well.
Nice little two-point lead here for Isaac Quek.
Three, four.
Oh, we went for it there.
Nice long serve. Always a surprise element. You got to use these weapons as a, I would say, at the right time. Mm. It was a very crucial point for Lin Wenru to do that, to make it all.
Yeah, you brought up the fact that it was a surprise how he started this match with a long serve as well. So he's clearly quite happy to use the variation, isn't he?
Yes, and that's the beauty of top players. They know when to use the surprise element. When will it be the most effective?
4-6.
Well, he shows Isaac Quek then he can stand up to these sort of rallies. Would it be fair to say, Neha, in this, in the lower ranked players, they know that because of the quality of their opponents, they don't necessarily want to go too long into points.
100%. You wanna wrap up the rally quickly because you know that if there is a long rally, they're generally the better one because they're faster, they're stronger, they take the contact early on, so it's better to keep it short.
He's got a 3-point lead here.
Ooh, how about that? That was so brutal.
Oh, that was a gorgeous shot from Lin Wenru. Have a look at this again. So good to watch. So natural, so clean, that shot from Lin Wenru. Isaac, though, still with that 2-point lead.
And five.
And he's increased that to 3. Stated recently he wants to win an Olympic medal.
Six, eight.
Still so much time ahead of him. Can get a result or two here, the world champs, it really will give him such a big boost. Looking to try and level things here at 1-1 if he can. 3 points to go. Oh,
seven.
Yeah, off the net. Played a big role in that, didn't it?
Yeah, the net cords just totally break the rhythm off the point, which it did here. Lin Wenru grabbing that opportunity. Perfect down the line, step around forehand.
Well, in the blink of an eye, he has drawn level. Lin Wenru was under a little bit of pressure when he was 3 down.
Yeah, but look at the amount of effort exerted in that backhand opening. It's just so beautiful to watch him make it look so effortless as well.
9-8.
Well, Isaac Quirk still fighting, still hanging on here. He's looking to try and press that home and take this second game.
Yeah, and that was an unforced error from Lin Wenru there. And coming at 8-8.
Oh,
and a second
deja
one.
Vu.
But credit to Isaac for giving that excellent serve, right? Both were totally different. This had a bit of a topspin there where you can see the top edge of the racket got hit. Just brilliant strategy from Isaac there.
He's done it. Isaac Quirk's taken.
Hold on your nerves as well. Be very calm and patient at this stage.
And, I mean, look at that. He's playing with confidence. How about that for the forehand down the line?
So beautiful to watch.
Fantastically delivered. And the pressure, there's no doubt about it. It's on Lin Wenru, right? Because he's the higher ranked players in the top 10.
Let 1-0.
Perfect angle. So how wide it was, that's the right thing to do. You force your opponent to make that move to the extreme forehand side, and especially for the left-handers, they can find those angles really well.
22-0.
I feel like the backhand opening for Lin Wenru is not really working too well from the forehand side. We'll see.
Now, these are the kind of rallies that give you such a boost when you win them.
Yeah, notice how he's steady, he's there on top of the ball. The contact point is just the sweetest point, right? He's executing it so perfectly.
3-0.
Yeah, he really made waves about 2 years ago, Isaac Quirk, when he became number one ranked under 15 boys player. First time that happened to a Singaporean. And he's just grown in stature since then.
3-4.
But he's you know, Lin Wenru is delivering shots like this. It's just outstanding.
And I would love to see more and more of these.
Yeah.
In the next coming few points.
5-3.
Nice. I think great change of place. You see the down the line backhand. Way too wide for Isaac Quirk to even react.
Yeah, puff of the cheeks there from Isaac.
20,
oh, how about that on the backhand? Lin Wenru just put his hands up like, how do I deal with that?
Bit of a jittery start.
There's a reaction from Lin Wenru. Just 1 point in it. It's one of the longer rallies. This time, Lin Wenru wins it.
Yeah, and the longer serve is actually working well for him. It gives him the opportunity to get pace in the rallies. So he's so much better than Isaac Quirk in longer rallies. And that's what he wants again and again.
Now he's got 3 points that lead for Lin.
Three, 7-5.
Just gone long again there, Lin. Slowly walking back to the table.
Making the right use of the towel break. Oh, that was a beautiful serve and even wonderful receiver from Isaac Quek. Look at that again. How low the ball went with a lot of spin in it. He tried a chop block, but maybe next time. An excellent service again with the very less spin on it. Just subtle changes in spin and speed make so much of a difference in a game of table tennis.
Yeah, those fine margins.
6-9.
Well, there's another case in point.
That was simply brilliant. The ball hit three times on the table. It is so hard to even control that.
10-6.
So one game point saved by Isaac Quek. Still got three more. Tough one here.
I was just thinking, is he going to make and be at your best?
One love.
But well, if you have folks like Isaac Quek hitting their absolute best, you're forced to put in your A game here. Simply brilliant from the Singaporean.
1-0.
Yeah, looks immediately back to Gao Ning after missing that backhand. Does well though. So we talked about the pressure on Lin Win Ru here, and while he's leading 2-1, it has not been a straightforward match for him thus far, has it?
Oh, not at all. It is a match of equals here.
3-0.
And that's a real credit to Isaac Quek and how he's holding his own. Tiebreak after every 6 points. Opportunity for players to kind of maybe think about things, reset a little bit.
Yeah, in an 11-point game of table tennis, things happen so fast that the towel break folks use to make the advantage of strategizing well.
4-3.
The flip side to that, of course, is that if you're doing well prior to the towel break, it kind of disrupts your momentum. You just want to carry on, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, I would debate on that. It works either ways, depending on what your mindset is.
3-5.
It's always good to take a pause, understand what's happening. Should I continue? Should I make any changes? So a lot going on in the minds of these players while they're playing on the table.
4, 5.
That's a good point. That's Isaac Quek drawing level.
Remember, it is best of seven. So Lin Win Ru, he wins this. He goes into a very nice 3-1 lead.
6-5.
Yeah, it's good for Lin Win Ru to start the serves from the backhand side. Slightly better hand for Lin Win Ru in this game.
Hoping to get yet another scalp in his already very impressive list.
6-0.
Brilliant opening. I think he's really finding the open spaces very well. I think the reading of the game is so brilliant by Isaac Quek here.
Well, those timeouts that you call are for your advantage, right? He's the one who wants to make the most of it. And then look at this.
Yeah, because he moves from the left to the right side so quickly.
Quick, yeah.
And is able to make this beautiful backhand opening. And yet again.
7-0.
But unsuccessful this time. Just the agility that is required by TT players to be moving on the court at such quick speed is mind-boggling.
F7.
Brilliant change of serve by Lin Win Ru. Totally proves why he is the current world number 9 to be thinking that smart at this point.
Yeah, why? A bit more on that. Why was that such a smart move?
Didn't see that at all in the match so far. It was actually slight topspin in the serve because you saw Isaac hit at the top edge.
So Isaac just edging in front here. Can he close us out to 2-2? That would be fantastic for him. Third ball attack. Wonderfully done. Isaac has 2 game points. He's playing some smart stuff, isn't he, Isaac Quek?
Yeah, wonderful shot placements. I think he's covering the court so well. Bit of a surprise for Lin Win Ru there.
He's done it. Isaac Quek has taken the second game.
We'll see. Game number 5.
One love.
And again, he starts off with that brilliant long serve. Just it seems like found the right spot for himself to start off the game.
Love.
Very well managed. It seems like he slipped a bit.
Let love 2. Love 3.
Yeah, it's interesting. When you look at Isaac Quek's overall record, it's 52%.
And against left-handers, he actually goes up. He's actually better against left-handers, 62%.
And that's a very safe and good start for Lin Wenru in this game five.
Best one he's had so far. Four unanswered points. Feels like he's just stepped up a gear, hasn't he?
And if I can see the replay there, it's brilliant in table tennis that how you got to make decisions in split of a second. He thought that the ball was sitting in, but he saw it came out and he went on for that attack.
One, five.
Well, he's finally got a point on the board here. Isaac Quek. You know, I was just thinking, Neha, that with all that strapping that we've seen on Lin's left forearm, it's in his interest to finish this off as quick as he can right now.
Yeah, and we've not seen really big forehands from him. He's actually trying a bit to give more effort from the backhand side. So I'm just maybe curious a bit if the forehand is an issue for him at all. Probably worth checking with him after this match if he's okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of strapping, isn't it?
7.
And I mean, if you're Isaac Quek, you'll have seen all that and you're thinking, well, maybe I'll try to put him on that forehand as much as I can.
Well, the court coverage from Lin Wenru has been absolutely fantastic.
Six of the last eight have gone Lin's way.
3-7.
There's a forehand. Wonderfully done by Isaac on his backhand. As he tries to battle back here in this fifth game.
And four.
So those are the things he would like to cut out on his end of things, right? You're already playing such a great player.
Yeah, and there was a very smart move. He went in for that opening, but then changed and made that soft chop and totally confused Isaac there.
Yeah, this is about as imposing a game as we've seen so far from Lin Wenru.
There's been absolute dominant from his backhand side. We've seen some really good attacks, finishing off the rallies with that.
5-9.
Yeah, for sure. He's not comfortable on the forehand side. You can see so many points gone through. In out of the five, probably three were from the forehand side.
6-9.
So just, you know, from Isaac's point of view, I mean, it's easier said than done, right? I want to try and get him to play on that forehand. But as you say, it's that coverage from Lin that makes it difficult to elicit shots from that forehand.
Yeah, because right there, Lin is going to the forehand side and making that backhand topspin. So it's really hard to figure out where do I even place the ball because he's covering most of the table from the backhand.
Four game points.
Oh, that was such a beautiful spins that they can make and force you to cover the table. Wider is the biggest advantages for being a left-hander. So for the righties, the spins are totally the opposite coming on your way.
One, 1-0.
Which makes it even more impressive. As I mentioned earlier, Isaac Quek, 62% win rate against left-handers, 48% win rate against right-handers. Of course, the sample size is a lot smaller. He's only played 8 matches against left-handers.
1-2.
But he's in a good position here. He's doing well.
That was a brilliant down-the-line forehand. Just a thunderous spin, smashy topspin there.
Two-all.
Got right across that, didn't he? There's the forehand. Looked all right there.
If you're on social media right now, go up to Isaac's Instagram and see how grateful he is for the sport. When he started playing at the age of 7 years old, he's just won 3 golds at the Correct. Southeast Asian Games, and he is so grateful for all the organizers and all the stakeholders in his career who's helped him be here where he is at 16 years of age only.
Yeah, he was so delighted with his achievements at those recent Southeast Asian Games, and he said it was a nice early birthday present for him. Said he was absolutely delighted, and he said it gave him a lot of confidence moving forward.
Which you can see here, it's 3-2 in the favor of Lin Wenru, but level all at 3-3.
Yeah, he's keeping pace with him.
And I tell you, these stages of the game is a lot of pressure, because for Isaac, he got to play catch up. This is the game where he could make it or break it.
Yeah, absolutely right. Because it's 7, right? So this game, if Lin wins it, obviously the match is over. So to stay in this, Isaac has to win this game.
4-all.
He got to find solutions to that long serve from Lin Wenru.
He's won every point on the long serve, hasn't he, so far? Lin Wenru.
Four-five.
Yeah, I think this might be the first time I've just seen the shoulders slump a little bit for Isaac Quek. I think the finish line is starting to come in sight for Lin Wenru, Nihan. Isaac, he's only a point behind, though. He's still in this.
Three-five-oh.
Yeah, a lot to do with body language, right? I'm a big fan of faking it till you make it. And if he can, not slouch and still go a bit more vocal, it puts a lot of pressure on your opponent, even though you're feeling a lot of nerves inside.
So some kind of a reverse psychology on your opponent.
6-5.
But, well, no answers to the long serve from Lin Wenru. Down the line long, he's having a lot of variations. That was a deep, long backspin. He's done side spins. He's done overspins. It's just a lot many weapons out there.
Did it again, didn't he? Actually, I think that might be the first time he's done 2 in a row long serves, which he hasn't done. But again, you as a player, you probably wouldn't expect him to do that 2 in a row, would you?
Yeah, and that creates a lot of pressure, because you know that you're not doing well on the long serves, and then you get another one, and then like, oh my God, what am I supposed to do?
I can't. It's clear that he's struggling with that, isn't he?
And it's also, closing towards 11.
Yeah, he's not far away. 4 points needed to win this match for Lin Wenru.
26-7.
Isaac, though, pulls one back. Oh, he knows it. Look at, what you didn't see there, just his reaction to losing the point. Yeah, he knows that was vital, because it's a 2-point cushion now for Lin. Just took the pace off a little bit.
Nice.
Oh, it hit the edge.
The edge. Let's have a look. Oh, how unlucky. I thought Isaac thought he'd won the point.
And so lovely for him to call it out.
He did.
Seven.
Oh, what a time to do that. Lin Winru. I wonder, is he feeling a bit nervy?
The gift of serve at this stage.
Time out.
Well. He's putting everything into it, but Lin Winru has set up match points.
This is what he needs, right? He's been waiting for this speed in the rallies, and that, look at that. He wins a point from his forehand side, which he's been struggling all this while.
So Lin Winru avoids a potential banana skin.